Hi there, Mr. Jim. How are you?
I am well, Drake. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm Drake Milligan, and this is my Opry debut.
Hey.
Hey.
That's pretty cool.
All right. You don't start crying yet.
We got a long day ahead of us.
Long day. Proudest I've been is him becoming an artist of his own. You know, people always told him what to play and what not to play, and he stood by his guns and he wants to be a traditionalist. And you know, this is the mecca of all traditionalists, is the Grand Ole Opry.
I'm from just south Fort Worth, Mansfield, Texas. My dad runs a scrapyard. My mom is a veterinarian. You know, and I grew up with their music, really, which was country music. George Jones, Merle Haggard, big fan of Western Swing. My dad's a big Bob Wills fan. So I grew up around all that.
Cleaning my truck, get it pushing 80, picking you up, and later maybe getting one kiss and going half crazy. Sounds like something I do.
My new album, Dallas Fort Worth, it was really a culmination of these 14 songs that I've written over the past really 5 years in Nashville. And Sounds Like Something I Do was actually, it was some of the most fun I've ever had in a writing room, was writing that song. I wrote it with Terry McBride and Brett Beavers. And I brought in that idea that one day and I said, all right guys, I want to write a barn burner. And we got in the chorus, it has this really fast paced line. And I ain't the kind to settle down and let myself get wrapped around somebody's finger, but if I had you, baby, sounds like something I do. So I was a senior in high school and I found out about open call auditions for Sun Records on CMT, a show that was going to tell the Sam Phillips story and show, you know, the lives of Elvis and Johnny Cash and Jerry Lee Lewis and Carl Perkins, the Million Dollar Quartet. And within a couple weeks, I got the call that I had the part on that show.
I really got into this CMT series called Sun Records because I played with Elvis. I was fascinated how that all came to be, the Million Dollar Quartet and stuff. And then I said, hey man, if you ever decide you want to make some records, let me know.
Tony Brown, I've been a big fan of for a long time. He played keys with Elvis back in the days and also produced just a million amazing country records, impactful country records. And then he brought in Brandon Hood to work with me.
I think there's like an authenticity of Drake. He's so well-rounded, whether it's like, you know, he's pulling from so many old school things, you know, all the 90s country that he and I both grew up loving and listening to and that we were just raised on. And so when we wrote, it was, you know, immediate connection.
I didn't expect to write every song on this record. I definitely didn't expect to. But I think it was just a process for me of finding my own sound and finding unique sounds. And the songwriting community here in Nashville is just the best.
Everybody that's in this kid's team is top notch, and that's what he's gonna bring to country music. And country music better watch out because it's fixing to be torn apart. It's coming big.
Staying too long at the honky-tonk, spending too much just to tie one on. A little less right and a lot more wrong. Sounds like something I do.
I mean, I was producing Patti Loveless when she played the Opry the first time. And I was producing Vince Gill when he got in the Opry. And so I know how important that is. If anybody deserves to be on the Opry, legitimate reason, Drake Milligan does.
I've had the pleasure of writing with Bill Anderson a few times, and I called him this week and asked him, hey, do you have any advice for me? And he said, the only thing I can tell you is what Minnie Pearl used to tell everybody. He said, you just go out there and love them, and they'll love you right back. So I'm gonna take that with me out on stage tonight.
We have an artist stepping into that circle for the very first time. Please welcome Drake Milligan.
Hello, Grand Ole Opry.
Having my Opry debut is really a milestone for me. You know, coming here today, it's kind of, you see the stage, you see the circle, you see all the huge names, all my heroes that have played here. You can feel the energy here, you can feel the reverence, you can feel the history, and to now be a part of that is really special.
I ain't the kind to settle down and let myself be wrapped around somebody's finger, but if I
great to have you here, and we hope to have you back.
Thank you, sir. I hope to be back as soon as possible.
Oh, thank you all very much.
Drake Milligan, everyone, making his Grand Ole Opry debut.